OKTAGON se vrací zpátky na Slovensko, kde se představí to nejatraktivnější, co domácí scéna nabízí. Šampion lehké váhy Ivan Buky Buchinger. Návrat Gábora Borároše. Bratislavský diamantový čávo Robo Pukáč. Šampion výzvy Samuel Pirát Krištofič. Ženský supertalent Monika Chochlíková. A když na Slovensko, tak rovnou na Nepelu a s fanoušky. Jedenáctého devátý Bratislava. Lístky v síti Ticketportál a živě na oktagon.tv.
Bantamová váha žen proti sobě postaví dvě dívky, které předvedly na půdě oktagonu fantastický výkon. Přesto obě odcházely poraženy. Rizlen Zuak, neboli také lvice z Atlasu, jak si nechává říkat, měla už na lopatě Silent Killer, Lucii Sabovou. Ta se však nakonec dokázala prodrat vítězství a připravit tak Zuak třetí porážku v kariéře. Zuak má na svém kontě 4 vítězství, všechny soupeřky dokázala ukončit před limitem a to samé plánuje i tentokrát v duelu s polskou bojovnicí Martou Valiček.
For me, Marta is a good opponent. It's a big challenge for me. It's gonna be intense war.
Valiček po zápase s Pudilovou pomalu zvedala rukou, když rozhodčí vyřkli jméno Lucie Pudilová. 33-letá Polka ze známého týmu Berserkers Bělsko-Běla se dožadovala odvety, ale k té se bude muset nejprve probojovat. Valiček má na svém kontě 4 vítězství, 2 ukončení a také mnoho titulů šampionky v postojářských disciplínách.
All my preparation to the fight are very, very, very strong. I'm crazy.
Čeká nás tvrdý a nesmlouvavý zápas dvou skvělých bojovnic.
So the ominous music of Marta Valicek rings out throughout the stadium here at Bobby Hall for Octagon 25, and there is a demeanor about this lady. And I stood next to her in the restaurant. She just oozes aggression. She is focused fully throughout the time she's been here. You can feel it, you can see it in her eyes right now. She is somebody who, in her own words in the build-up, said, "I am crazy. I let that go within the cage." And you can feel it, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Look at this smile. Yeah. Scary.
That's that scary smile.
Like, I'm going to do something really bad to somebody in a minute. But let's talk about her skill set, not just her demeanor, because she also had a baptism of fire at Octagon, where she took on Pudilova at Octagon 21, and she gave her a great fight. Pudilova, though, known for that pressure, known for being so well-rounded, and she showed that in that fight. She mixed up the strikes with the grappling, with the aggression, with the forward pressure. And Valicek was very game, gave a really good account of herself, particularly in the striking realms. Her kick, her lead kick is deceiving, it's deceptively quick. But Pudilova just overcame that. But Valicek, for me, earned some credit within that fight about how good she is and the problem she could cause anybody in the bantamweight division.
Yeah, plus, I don't think that there's better competition than Pudilova. Right now, it's going to be, her opponent will be test for her, but not, it won't be that huge obstacle which Pudilova was.
Yeah, and you're talking, and I agree completely. Pudilova, she's got the experience. She's been all over the world trying herself against some of the, she comes from a great camp. She mixes up camps, going Poland and in the Czech Republic. She is a phenomenal talent. And that is pretty much the toughest test you could draw in your debut. Both ladies in the cage. Niceties as they touch gloves will be over when they face off in just a couple of minutes. To get it underway, to get us started, we need one man, we need the man.
Yeah, there's television tape. 5 centimeters taller.
And a huge Valicek. Favorite, Valicek, as well.
Huge favorite.
Je před námi první ze dvou ženských zápasů, tentokrát bantamová váha 61 kg, 3 kola po 5 minutách, a vaším rozhodčím v oktagonu je Michal Popelák. Pojďme si představit obě ženy. Nejprve Modrý roh. 34 let, 165 cm, 61,7 kg na váze. MMA Factory Gym pod trenérem Faisalem Husinem. Má na svém kontě 6 zápasů, 4 vítězství, všechny ukončila před limitem a pouze 2 porážky. Za Maroko, dnes večer, v Modrém rohu, Rizlan Lioness of the Atlas Zouak! Červený roh. 33 let, 170 cm, 60,8 kg na váze. Das Berserker Team pod trenérem Damianem Herčíkem má na svém kontě 7 zápasů, 4 vítězství, 2 ukončila před limitem a 3 porážky. Dnes večer v Nerudově poháru za deepcbd.cz a za Polsko v červeném rohu Marta Wadera Valicek!
Ladies, listen my instruction. I say stop, you stop. Check your hands and go back. Good luck.
So they touch gloves before they go to war. Marta Valicek in the red corner, taking on Rizlan Zouak in the blue corner. France versus Poland here at Octagon 25. Me, Brian Lacy, alongside Jan Malak, calling the action for you. And off we go.
Off we go for the 4th fight of tonight's card.
Zouak, that southpaw stance. You know she's got to look to clinch, and that's exactly what she goes. And look at the trips.
Wow.
And again.
And again. Look. She's trying to set up that outside leg trip.
And that's the, oh, that's the lead high kick. And you can just see the difference in their striking, even the motions. You can see he comes up the middle there.
She stuffed the takedown, plus she was able to add that left knee to it.
just look how fluid the striking combinations are coming from Valacek. And again, using those strikes to try and get inside and get the... big knees.
Big knees to the midsection.
Valacek started combat sports just age 11, literally has been her life. Has held titles in other organizations as well, competes in kickboxing on top of that. Just somebody who loves the fire, the fury, the intensity of competition. And Rizlan Zuek almost looks like she's out of ideas already. Every time she steps in, she's met with horrendous strike, just like that.
And I think that Zoak's bad habit is that she keeps turning. Watch out for the leg.
Oh, looking control the head. But I think you're about to say what I've got written down here, which she turns her back into her opponent. So she's looking for that judo throw. But actually, it puts you in a very vulnerable position. That's exactly how she lost the position to finally be armbarred by Zvabova. And it's great having that. And she's obviously so. Looking for the guillotine here up against the cage.
And she lost it, but she's in a good spot right now.
Just overwhelming her with absolute ferocity. And
I like what I've seen so far.
Yeah.
Very entertaining fight. Wow.
Oh,
just pouring on Zoek.
Now she's got to be careful getting back to her feet as well. Does well though. Now she's got that clinch again. Looks for the chip. That's great work. Now she's on top.
Yeah, she's on top right now.
This is where she wants it. Now what can she do with it? Looking to keep control of Valacek. Slowly just trying to progress her position, but Valacek looks very calm here.
Yeah, very calm because Zoak is
only
holding her
almost. Pushes away.
She pushes her away. And right now both women are on their feet.
And again, that was a nice technical way of getting back to your feet. She made space. She almost completed.
There's the high kick rocked her.
Kick right up the middle. You heard that. You saw the grimace as well from Valacek.
But Valacek's got to press the action. She's got to press the action right now. Strong tip.
I think the cup kick, the kick up the middle has actually stifled her a little bit.
Maybe, yeah. But I would follow that same strategy. Throw 2-3 punches and then finish with a leg.
Zuek is so impressive as far as how she gets you to the mat. That's the third different trip she's used. She's not been able to do anything with these positions yet, but still.
Yeah, she's able to hold Valacek down, but on the other hand, she's not doing anything when it comes to damage.
Yeah, 10 seconds left in this first round.
So I'm pretty confident this round should go to Valacek.
I think certainly the more significant strikes, the majority of the action that way. But Zuek has eaten what's been given to her, survived and ended the round on top. And it's maybe that little mental thing she'll take back into the corner. And she's been able to get Valacek to the mat when she has connected. She's been able to get her down there using that judo, using those clever trips that she's got in her arsenal. But on the feet, Valacek just looks to hurt you every time she touches you.
Yeah, and Zoak was in that last round, Zoak was in so many bad spots. I mean, like that bad position when it comes to, you know, turning on the wrong side.
Yeah.
But she's still there.
She is still.
And she was able to take Valicek down.
Another fantastic matchup here at Octagon 25. Oh, look at the frame she uses for those knees. Look how strong she is. And again, that buries deep into the midsection.
That frame is very important.
And here's another one of those. It's the outside trip. Basic, but executed beautifully. Round two. Set to get underway, scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds here at Octagon 25. And off we go again. Oh, wow.
Yeah, and
again,
but this was after a spinning attack, but still. Oh, another two knees to the midsection.
Wow, and again.
Third one.
Oh, that was stunning.
Yeah.
Literally, timber. Down she went beautifully.
How she knew about the position, the pivot. I know.
Stunning execution beautiful. There of the beautiful. Technique. Controlled the upper body, then pulled the, literally reaped the leg away from up to get it to the mat.
And watch out for those knees to the midsection again. She's got space for it, but no.
And again, you saw Zuat trying to turn it into a throw. Oof. Another spinning back fist attempt there.
But so far, I'm very impressed by Zoa. I thought that it's going to be more one-sided in favor of Valicek, to be honest. But Zoak is doing a great job.
And she's also eating everything that Valicek is throwing at her, so that the knees,
she doesn't look concerned.
Yeah, and as the person throwing those weapons, Valicek, that's got to mentally sort of go, what else do I have to hit this person with to really switch the tide of the momentum of the fight?
Single leg attempt. Defended by Zoak. How many total strikes landed to the midsection or on the belly?
Yeah, if you add up the knees and that, look at that sweet elbow there. Well, there's a cut.
Whoa, beautiful spinning attack by Valicek.
Oh, that looks like a cut right on the eyebrow there. Oh, and again.
And again.
Solid grappling there from Zuak.
Just like you said, basic takedown, basic trip, but it works.
It's the execution, perfect technique and timing as well. There's timing with regards to striking, like your jab or your rear hand, but there's also within the grappling realms, you can make your life easier if you time things right, if you do it in the right momentum at the right moment. The blood now starting to cover the mid. Oh, straight
arm. Oh, watch out for an armbar.
Yeah.
And Valicek is. Yeah, both of her legs were trapped in that position.
Valicek is still working. He looked for it to scoot to the fence, try and get up. Pushes away, kicks the midsection there. Zuat coming
for
hard.
For the second time, Valicek just pushed her away. And again.
1 minute, 25 seconds left in this second round.
And that cut is nasty.
That is nasty. Oh, a little slip there as well. A little mistake just in the footing. Valicek.
Wow, that's deep.
Cranking that neck. But that is going to be an interesting fight. Oh, another solid elbow there from Valicek.
1 minute left in the second round.
Oh, shots to the midsection. Zuak is tough. My goodness.
Tough.
Belichick burying those cornrows into the midsection, under the chin now. Trying to pull away that single leg. I mean, do you think this is a wise game plan here against Zuak? Would you like to see us separate, maybe strike some more?
Yeah, I think even wiser would be if they would separate. And if Belichick would try to finish this one. Wow.
Slick work to take to the back. Now these elbows coming down. Look at this. Trying to free that hand.
Yeah. Zuak knows that she's got that hand trapped.
She's got both hands trapped. That's some grip. Wow. Deep breaths there from Belichick again. She must be wondering what she has to hit this lady with to finish this fight. But Zuak, now we'll see. Hopefully we'll get a little glimpse of that cut. Hasn't caused much problems as well as far as blood getting in the eyes so far there of Zuak. But this, like you said, when you look at it on paper, even when you watch the fights back, you look at the technical ability of Belichick and you think she's got so much more weapons in her arsenal that this could be an easy night for her. But Zuak is so tough. She's so good at and even drawing Belichick into the fight that she wants. These positions where she can get hold of her and take her down, use those trips. Oh, more knees to the midsection.
And there's that beautiful spinning attack that landed perfectly.
And another great trip there. They really are putting on a show for us here, Octagon 25. My goodness. And you look at this as a fight, and then you look at the division. So like we talked for Delova, Zvabova. It's great. It's great to see. This is showing that there's real depth now growing within these weight classes.
Oh!
Big attack to start off round number three from Belichick. The odds are
pretty much takedown attempt by Belichick. But how many shots to the midsection Zoa can take? Those spinning attacks are lethal, usually.
And the knees in as well, from the clinch.
Yeah.
Oh, looking for the armbar, looking for the armbar is Zuak. Wow, can she go belly down? This could be an amazing comeback. Can she finish this? Oh!
And you know what?
Wow.
Yeah, it's the third round.
Yeah.
They're slippery again.
There's blood in there. Yeah. As well. So Belichick, you look at the significant strikes. There's 63 from Belichick, 9 Zuak.
Whoa! Nice uppercut attempt by Zuak. Oh, inside leg kick by Belichick.
The movement of Belichick, though, has slowed a little. Look at those steps, much more labored. Understandably so, she's had to work very hard in this fight.
Another hard kick to the body.
But she just catches it, doesn't even blink. Oh, another spinning attack. She loves those spinning back fists. Looking for the throw, now look at it. She puts the hips inside. See if she can execute this, but again, they're going to be slippery and sweaty. It's crazy, but I think Zuak looks the fresher of the two in this third round.
This fight will be pretty hard to score.
Yeah, you look at the shots now. Those elbows, the pop seems to have gone out of them a little from Belichick. She's hit Zuak so many times. You look at the difference in the significant strikes and how powerfully she's been throwing them as well.
Yeah, but in this last round, Zuak is the one who's pressing action.
Yeah, and she's mixing it up with strikes. She's showing us stuff we haven't seen from her before. That kick to the midsection, the uppercut. Belichick driving forward, trying to contain Zuak. Oh. to try and set up.
Good pressure on the headlock by Zoak.
Oh, hook for hook. Charging in for the takedown again, looking for the chip, yeah, and gets it. I don't think she's failed.
So great in this, but yeah, because Valicek defended that takedown attempt. She sprawled, she did everything right, but in the end, Zoak followed through and got that inside leg trip and was able to take Valicek down.
1 minute 30 seconds left in this third and final round. A round where you just saw the significant strikes come up, and back up to 24 now is Zoak. Certainly, for my money, is taking this round. Oh, a solid uppercut. Look at the trip. That's great technique. Helping arm.
Watch out for
maybe
for the reverse triangle, maybe, but
scarf hold, maybe.
Zoak's got one minute to finish this.
She has that left arm deep and around the back of the head there of Valicek.
But it's bad for your balance when it comes to that, this position.
She's
got a lot of weight on that upper body.
Not quite a rear naked choke. Valicek trying something.
Yeah, watch out for that reverse triangle.
Yes.
Just like I said.
Great, and Valicek looking to take the... Oh, the arm. This could
arm.
Could be an armbar attempt here.
She's got 18 seconds. I know this won't probably will... probably won't be 10-8 round, but still... Great effort by Zoak.
Wow, what a turnaround. Still got that arm in trouble. Wow.
Wow.
Zoak raising her hand. That, if you show me the first round, there's no way I believe the third round is going to finish like that. Credit to Zoak. And we said this matchup really is going to be a fantastic one to see where they stand in the division. They gave each other all they had.
And that's what is beautiful about MMA.
How do you feel?
You never know.
And there we have the significant strikes. Look at that, 167-50, 64-27. Takedown attempts, 1-4, one submission attempt there. The numbers are great. Look at the output. That shows how good that fight was.
Yeah, and it also shows that it was a striker against grappler matchup.
Yes. This is the armbar attempt. Valicek stays composed.
Yeah, those stats there was written only one submission attempt, and maybe probably two, because there was armbar also.
Yeah.
In that almost crucifix-like position.
Oh, paying back one of those knees to the midsection. Absolute warriors, Jan. Absolute warriors.
Yeah.
And there was no quitting either of them. There was not a moment where you felt either of them mentally broke. They tired, maybe. They got cut, they got bloodied. But mentally, they were still giving everything they could. That takedown for me was my favorite. Beautiful. 15 minutes they've shared, given all they could to try and kill each other in there. Obviously, metaphorically, but then one winner will walk out victorious. Let's find out who it is.
Pojďme se podívat na to, jak to viděli rozhodčí. So, let's see how the judges scored this fight. 29-28, 29-28 a 29-28. All three judges scored this fight 29-28. For the winner, pro vítězku, kterou se stává Marta Vadera Valicek. Marta? Can we speak English or po polsky?
We can try.
We can try?
Yeah.
Ryslan is very disappointed.
So I prefer Polish.
Okay. Ryslan nie jest zadowolona z tego
rezultatu?
To znaczy, powiem tak, miałam długą przerwę, jeśli chodzi o walki zawodowe w oktagonie, bo moment tak naprawdę z zeszłego roku kalendarzowego przepracowałam bardzo intensywnie na sali treningowej, w związku z tym, że wszystko było zobostrzone przez pandemię. Tych startów było niewiele, także to jest mój taki pierwszy prawdziwy start. Tym bardziej się cieszę, bo zawodniczka dla mnie bardzo imponująca, jeśli chodzi o doświadczenie, jeśli chodzi o walkę, o swoją postawę, bo to już wcześniej w wywiadzie mówiłam, że bardzo mi się to w niej podoba, że ma tego ducha sportowego. Startowała w olimpiadzie, jest bardzo dobrą judoczką, co zresztą widać na jej walkach reprezentacji kraju. No nic, tylko się cieszyć. Fajnie, bo plan na tą walkę został, powiedzmy, w 80-70% zrealizowanych. Także jeszcze dużo pracy przede mną.
Oczekiwałaś, że będziesz zwycięzcą po tej trzeciej rundzie?
Jeszcze raz?
Jeśli oczekiwałaś, że będziesz zwycięzcą po tej trzeciej rundzie?
Tego nie można nigdy być pewnym. To każdy zawodnik, przygotowując się do walki, liczy na swoje zwycięstwo i to, żeby zostawić w tej klatce jak najwięcej serca. Każdy z nas liczy na zwycięstwo, a potem walka już weryfikuje. Ale bardzo się cieszę z rezultatu.
Dziękujemy, gratulujemy.
Z tego miejsca chciałam jeszcze raz bardzo podziękować organizatorom Oktagonu za kolejną możliwość startu na tak zacnej gali, że miałam możliwość w końcu spotkać kibiców na sali, co tak naprawdę jest nowością w ostatnim czasie. Pozdrawiam wszystkich. Chciałam podziękować mojemu trenerowi Damianowi Herczyk z Berserker Team Bielsko-Biała. Das Berserker Team Bielsko-Biała, chłopakom z klubu za cały ten wkład i pracę. Tak naprawdę do każdej walki spotykamy się codziennie i zostawiamy tony potu na sali. Moim rodzicom, którzy mocno trzymają kciuki, mojej całej rodzinie, przyjaciołach, bo wchodzę do oktagonu sama, ale tak naprawdę za mną stoi sztab ludzi, którzy bardzo mocno mnie dopingują i za to wam wszystkim dziękuję.
My dziękujemy, Marta, i wierzymy, że będziemy cię zobaczyli w następnych galach.
Mam taką nadzieję. Bardzo dziękuję.
Dziękuję bardzo, Marta. Dziękuję. Marta Maliček. Jenom možná rychlosti přeložím, že Marta na konci děkovala rodině, samozřejmě, že do oktagonu vejde sama, ale že je zatím práce celého týmu. Říkala, že Zuak je skvělou sportovkyní, že je vynikající judokou, že byla na olympiádě, že to byla těžká soupeřka a že nikdy nemůžeš vědět, když to skončí na body, jestli skutečně si vyhrála, ale že tomu pevně věřila a že udělala maximum pro to vítězství a na závěr jsme si slíbili, že se tady zase uvidíme na nějakém následujícím turnaji. Tolik tedy Marta Valiček, jedna z vítězek dnešního turnaje.
Mohli jste mi říct všechno, vzali jste mi peníze, vzali jste mi pás, ale vítězství jste mi vzít nemohli. Protože v oktagonu je pořád jenom jeden král.
Terminátor si jde proto, co kvůli pár dekům ztratil.
Dejte mi můj belt, dejte mi dalšího soupeře a dejte mi můj belt, já chci zpátky.
Carlos Vémola v bitvě o titul šampiona střední váhy s polským vyzivatelem Marcinem Naruškou.
Vémola musí počuť moju pravou i levou rękę. Musí po prostu ležet i płakać po walce.
Já vím, že vyhraju pro to, jak dřu. Já tam radši chcípnu, než abych nevyhrál. Budu mě milovat, budu mě nenávidět, ale hlavně, že ten titul budu mít jak přes pravý, tak přes levý rameno. Jakože se Terminátor jmenu.
Přání fanoušků byla vyslyšena. Miloš Meloun Petrášek se konečně vrací do akce. Šampion lehké váhy Ivan Buky Buchinger v superfightu. Lucia Silent Killer Sabová hodlá čelit své dosud největší výzvě v podobě švédské bojovnice Cornelie Hall. Rozjetý Matouš Juráček je po skalpu Gábora připraven vyzvat španělského El Spectacula Primeru. A chybět nebudou ani domácí ženská jednička Lucie Pudilová, bomber Leo Brichta. A to vše doprovázené elektrizující atmosférou pod otevřeným nebem na ikonické Štvanici v Praze. Živě na octagon.tv.